Jamaican music, reggae music, is all about our island and about our black culture. In Jamaica, everybody wants to make music. It's a desperately poor country, and most youths can't get work. If your chance comes, it comes only once, and you have to grab it. There's record producers, men like Jack Ruby, that hopeful young singers go to. If he likes what he hears, he can make you a star. That's how it's always been in Jamaica.
You can't run, you can't hide. You can't run, you can't hide. I'm the fury of Jah Jah. Yeah, many are calling, few are chosen. The gift of Jah is eternal life. Wages of sin is death. Oh yeah.
You take the man your songs, wait your turn, and hope to God Jack Ruby will like them.
Oh yeah, this world is over. Let us go, let us go. Kinsmen, let us all try to know the good, bad, and indifferent. Cause what we know ain't so fishy. And black man, there's no time for you to segregate. Step forward and dictate. Oh yeah, oh Jah, your children have no peace in Babylon, Jah. Don't turn your back on righteous Rastaman. You know, to them feeds are really, you know? Yeah, you know, man like it, man like it.
Yes,
right now.
Man, them think about that tune, ask you.
If Jack likes what he hears, he can take you away from the hills, down to the Kingston Recording Studios. That's where you both hope to make money.
Since the 1960s, it's been the same old story. The music may have changed its name from rocksteady to ska and then to reggae, but the struggle is always the same, even for those who were later to become stars, like Toots and the Maytals.
Tell me, baby, what wrong have I done you?
Tell me, baby.
the same for Jimmy Cliff.
From the beginning, I was making.
Jimmy's an international star now, but the struggles he went through have left their scars.
People say justice is a notion, but it's something real for me. There's so much injustice going on in this business, which I don't intend that I alone can fight the battle. But I'd like to see some justice done, you know? Get paid for what you're due, you know? People don't feel no farmer guilt that if they use you and you are, you're ignorant of the fact that they're using you. They don't feel any farmer guilt. So, part of my job is to say what I know to them, to put them on the guard. I don't want to be the pawn and the chessboard to be pushed by whoever is playing. I want to be the pusher, to control myself and to give opportunity to less fortunate who is now in the position that I once was in. Wanted man, I'm a wanted man right now in the world. You see, I'm a wanted man. I'm a wanted, wanted man. I'm a wanted, wanted man. I'm on the road.
Reggae music only really sounds right when it's recorded in Jamaica. Kingston's full of little studios in almost every side street. This is where the music happens. Like Scratch's home, which is also his studio.
Feeling fresh, feeling good, feeling out the way man. I said today, feeling rain, rock-a-rock-a high.
Junior Mervyn, Upsetters, and the Heptones all rehearse here.
Scratch's real name is Lee Perry. He regards all the greats, including Bob Marley. Even Paul McCartney is coming here from England, because Scratch has a sound and a rhythm of his own. He calls it rockers. When Scratch begins a session, first he balances drum and bass for the basic rhythm. Ghetto music, always drum and bass. Then Scratch will balance all the other instruments till he's ready to start recording. Thank you. When the balance is right, the upsetters lay down the rhythm track. That's how reggae is recorded.
Let's go. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Though there seems to be no kind of order or discipline, Scratch knows exactly what he wants, and the musicians respect that.
1, 2, 3, 4.
The people's standards, the instruments may sound distorted, the balance way off. But it's just these rough edges that give reggae the kind of raw sound they can never copy abroad. When Scratch is happy with the rhythm, he'll get Junior Mervin and the Heptones to put the vocals on. Rhythm and then lyrics. That's how Scratch describes reggae. Rhythm from the ghetto, lyrics from the streets.
Yes, Rasta.
Play on, Mr. Music. Play on.
Won't you?
Play on, Mr. Music. Play on.
Say the chalice is burning, the jammers are rolling.
Reggae music is much more than just entertainment in Jamaica today. It's a powerful social force that mirrors the pressures of everyday life, putting them into words and rhythm, describing, revealing, persuading. Politicians all use reggae as a central part of their campaign and policies. Prime Minister Michael Manley and his party had their own song written for them.
Socialists are no fool.
In Jamaica, you can't separate music from politics anymore.
I'd like to thank you for your very kind reception. And I can see that you're ready. More than ready.
We have them and the manners.
It's out of poverty and violence of Kingston eras like Jonestown and Trenchtown that this music's grown. That's why it's called ghetto music. We think of Joe Higgs as the first Trenchtown artist.
Music originated from the confrontation of the struggle. So the roots really, it's from a matter of struggle. That's where it's from. It's not even good to be known that you are from Trenchtown. This is the kind of strength that you have to really accumulate. Reggae is a confrontation of sound, man. Reggae has to have that basic, vibrant sound, which is to be heard in a ghetto is like playing the bass very loud, the drum. You know, those are the basic sounds. A classical reggae should be accepted in a part of the world in the same sense. Freedom. That's what it's asking for. Acceptance. What it needs. And understanding. You know. That's what reggae is saying. You have a certain love come from hard struggle, long suffering. A certain love that through pain gird itself with that hope for freedom. Not to give up. It may not sound like a reggae now, but it is.
Every day my heart is sore, seeing that I'm so poor. I shall not give up so easy no more. There's a reward for me. There's a reward for me. Though I'm burdened down with shame, there's no one for me to blame. But I shall not give up so easy, no, no. There's a reward for me. Everybody say, there's a reward for me. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. You know no one cares for me. I've never known sympathy. Sometimes I look to this world with a smile. Man, you hear what I say. Every day my heart is sore. See that I'm so poor. I shall not. I won't give up so easy, no. There's a reward for me. There's a reward.
Sizing more on the rhythm.
One good thing about music when it hits.
But to break it down, bring it down to a proportionate piece in the sense of like rock steady or reggae. To bring the attraction not on the music but on the message.
Hit me with music, man. This ain't the French style rock.
because it's the message that was really matters.
You reap what you sow.
But it's really to deal with the people. I can't specify it, but I have something to do with the people. Not politically, spiritually. It's a rhythm that's very contemporary. Lyrically, it's the cry of the people. Some giving a message, some talking about the oppression of the poor, some talking about wars, and some talking about love. So this is how I see reggae, what is known as reggae today.
Go, but forward we go, forward we go. And it's seven times to rise and seven times to fall, but the harder they come is the harder they fall. And you can get it if you really, really want. All you gotta do is try and try.
We are reggae, so no.
Smashing up the boys and girls. We gotta turn, turn. And I say, let's turn the table, 'cause I know that we are able.
Struggle has molded most of the top reggae people. They fight their way through. The Gladiators come from there. So does Hardman, Prince Tony, their producer. Them work together well, speaking the same language, putting it into music and then onto a record.
I'm a man of prayer. None of my doings shall never go wrong. Jah hear I when I cry. Jah hear I when I cry. 'Cause I'm a great meditator.
Yeah, an engineer.
I'm a great meditator.
You're an engineer. No more time.
Trying to destroy.
Prince Tony and engineer Errol Thompson can take hours just to get a balanced award.
Music alone shall live. And I see the light through music.
It's an instinct for the music. It's a feeling that's grown inside you from the streets and tenement yards, and it breaks out into music. Reggae music.
Diamond don't deal in no kind of hearsay.
Hearsay.
Back where with that and come straight. If you are come,
if you are come, you are come.
Say them are the general, them are the big chief.
The big chief.
What the winning judge in
this game. Like the voice, you know, by itself, you know.
The bass line.
Remember this little saying, that bush of ears.
Listen,
go to it's nonsense. You'll get the answer.
You got the answer.
Bush don't have ears, my friend. Someone may be in it.
hearing what you have said about your brothers.
Brothers, brothers.
Hearing what you have done in the past, cause every secret sin must reveal.
That same studio, Joe Gibbs, also presses and packages its own records.
Yeah. Keep your mouth shut and don't say a word, y'all.
Big studios control the business in Jamaica. Artists gather at the record stores to check how their discs are selling. It's about the only way they can find out. Reggae is still called a rip-off game. So Randy's isn't just Jamaica's biggest record store. It's a kind of waterhole for reggae musicians.
That the economic crisis done. Show them that the economic crisis done. Tell them that the
my father Banya.
Do the smell on your face while passing through.
Not much music happens live in Jamaica nowadays. It's mostly on disc. But one of the biggest selling bands sometimes takes its music direct to the people.
Jamaica's rising star, the mighty, mighty diamonds. Come on, let's hear it. Come on. Yeah. No, no, no.
Marcus Galvin prophesies, eh? Oh, yeah. Man, I go find a man against the wall.
Away from the clubs and the shops, reggae depends on a few radio shows to get the music to the people. So the reggae disc jockeys are very influential.
These are troubled times, and every Jamaican man sometimes, or every Ethiopian man sometimes, feels the need to turn to a source of inspiration or a source of strength. All strength is inside of man, and all you have to do is turn inside to find all strength. If you want something to read to assist you in finding strength, turn to that proverb which says, hey, the more you give is the more you get. And hey, Job 28, verse 12, right till 28. Job 12, verse 28, right till 28. check it. You might just find something. You might just want to, you know. He's I and I, superstar, Mr. Music, Bob Marley.
Marley's music goes beyond the lyrics and spirit of the ghetto. Marley has taken to people everywhere the message of Rastafari, the faith most reggae musicians aim to live by. Rastafarians trace their cultural roots back to Africa, from where their fathers came as slaves. And many hope one day to return there. It can also be a very convenient way of not seeing what surrounds you. You can as easily shut your mind with prayer and herb as open it. Below the hills, in the ghettos, political gang wars, looting and burning still happen. The Socialist Party has started to clean up the ghettos, but on a very selective basis. Years of British colonial rule, followed by American big business and tourism, did little to distribute real wealth among Jamaicans. Instead, it's shifted Jamaica further towards socialism, as she struggles to assert her independence as a part of the Third World.
The single out relationship with Cuba, which is part of that whole regional cooperation, but it is not an isolated relationship. It is only one relationship in a series of third world relationships because we are a part of the third world.
So the Rastafarian faith can be seen as an assertion of cultural independence. Rastafari was really founded in the 1930s by Marcus Garvey, a Jamaican who preached black pride and an awareness of African roots. Some reggae is still called roots music.
Yo.
Michael's music is of traditional Ethiopian style. Its lyrics are about racial identity, about exile in a Babylon called Jamaica, and the hope of one day returning to the spiritual homeland. Reggae music, through the sale of records, spreads ideas and culture more than any politics or newspapers.
There are some musicians who spread the faith, but they're almost never seen. They live in the ghetto areas, inside the churches, but they are a real force in Jamaican society, like the Abyssinians.
Land far, far away, where there's no night, there's only day. Look into the book of life and you will see that there's a land far, far away. King of kings and the Lord of lords sit upon his throne and he rules us all. Look into the book of life and you will see that he rules us all.
The songs of the Abyssinians have become a spiritual thing. There are even sung as hymns in the Ethiopian churches.
Rastafarians believe that Haile Selassie, king of Ethiopia, is the living god. They call him Jah. 10 years ago, he came to Jamaica. It was like God flying in to visit the faithful. They still sing of it.
In the person of Haile Selassie first, victorious.
Far, far away.
I see your bright sunshine in every morning, Lord, then a shower of rain.
Give thanks and praise, give thanks and praise.
Can be sweet when you wake.
about your earthly possessions, yeah.
Don't make it holy, yeah. Don't make it holy,
in
yeah.
these obsessions.
I see the glory in the morning sun. I see your glory when the day is done.
However sophisticated reggae music gets, and a band like Third World has many Western influences, its roots are still firmly in Jamaican culture. Mobile discotheques called sound systems travel all around Jamaica, taking the music and its message out from the studios direct to the people. The DJs sing their own local message over other people's records, like young Hugh Brown, who models himself on the great U Roy. U Roy was the first, singing of Trench Town and Babylon Burning. He's something of a legend.
Bands in Jamaica now, perhaps the one that's most in demand is Inner Circle, with the Lewis Brothers and Jacob Miller. They work together closely at home on their new numbers.
In all the Inner Circle songs, it's the lyrics, the words that matter, as much as the music.
I give them songs for the people to unite. I feel the people should unite at this
point. Yeah. Teaching them not to fight.
Right.
Come on, come on, as we start to discipline.
Manners must turn to discipline, order in court, militant style.
I miss a sing them songs of culture, I miss a sing them songs of love, songs for the people to unite, teaching them not to fight. Manners must turn to discipline.
The rhythm of Forward Ever is reggae, up-tempo. The words Forward Ever are about Rasta, but more strongly about Jamaican society now, about trying to live together in peace, about not giving up.
I have a chorus, man, I have a verse.
You go from songs for the people to unite, man. Songs for the people to unite, teaching them not to fight.
Yeah.
Manners must turn to discipline. That's what your justice will bring.
Inner Circle live up in Kingston, Beverly Hills, way above the ghetto. It's a contradiction that doesn't seem to worry them. They are Jamaicans and they're tied to the people through their music. Roger Lewis called the music a summing up of Jamaican lifestyle. Reggae is music with a real social force, with the power to get things changed.
want everyone to jump and shout.
But reggae is also looking for an international market and the big time. Some of us don't think it can do both. Reggae right now in Jamaica is something unique. And like the society it plays for, a change is going to come.
It was all night till daylight. All night till daylight. I see one in a pike hill, the other in a blue book. When the music take them rasta, them say ice roots, not the roots. It was all night till daylight. All night till daylight. Hey, I said all night, everyone till daylight. All night till daylight. Chester, it wear polyester.